Welcome to the PNN Media Camp. I'm Linnea.
And I'm Gabby. This past week, us and a group of middle school students have worked with Penn students to create a show we have today.
Starting off, the Penn debate team is heading to nationals in Des Moines, Iowa next week.
Let's hear all about it from the fellow reporters, Brooklyn Anderson and Evelyn Gregory.
Penn High School recently qualified for the debate state championships in Des Moines, Iowa. PNN interviewed director Jeremy Starkweather and debate students currently preparing for the tournament.
Who qualified for the nationals competition?
So we actually had 20 students qualify for nationals this year in both speech and debate. Which is actually the most students that I've ever had qualify in my history as a coach. So we're really excited. We are actually taking two full minibuses on a road trip to Des Moines, Iowa. So it's a big group. It's going to be fun. The winner gets a $5,000 scholarship and a giant trophy. So we're hoping we can get somebody to that final round. It'll be really cool.
What does training look like for nationals?
So training actually right now over in my classroom and in some of the other classrooms in the 190s hallway, pretty much the whole team is here. We're researching, we're prepping our arguments. Right now I have a group of kids who are about to do a practice round of debate. And so it's a lot of work up front, and then we're kind of just resharpening our skills with the public speaking since it's been a little while since we've competed, since our season really ended in about April. So we're just tuning up, getting ready. We have whole new topics that we're debating, and so we're doing some research and, getting ready to compete. So this is the Traveling Policy State Trophy. So this trophy has been around since 1928. So this year, Sarah Ahmed and Lynn Chung were able to bring this back home to Penn High School. It actually hasn't been back in this building since I won this in 2013, so that's pretty cool. They finally brought it home to me.
What was your guys' experience for speech and debate?
For me, it's been a pretty good experience. It's been sort of the main thing I've been involved in academically, and I feel like it's taught me a lot of academic skills, public speaking, research, and overall just been a really good time. I've met a lot of new people through it, too.
As a person who is a not native English speaker, I came into this club hoping to improve my English. That did not happen. Overall, it was a lot of pain, suffering, and tears. But over these 3 years of pain, I'm happy I was able to contribute to making Penn great.
For Penn News Network, we are Brooklyn Anderson and Evelyn Gregory.
Thanks, guys. This week and last week have been very busy for many Penn students. Camps such as Learn to Swim, Robotics, and POMS have taken place here at Penn. Lily has more information on the Learn to Swim camp.
Over summer break, Penn High School has many summer programs. The Learn to Swim program has three sessions through July and June. Session 1 is from June 10th to 21st. Session 2 is June 24th to 28th and July 8th to the 13th. Session 3 is July 15th to the 26th. The cost for swim camp is $40 per child every session. The registration is online through the PHM website. There are a small amount of spaces available every year, and registration began in April. I'm Lilia for PNN.
Thanks, Lilia. And now to Karina to learn all about Penn Robotics Camp.
Robotics has held their summer camp these past 2 weeks. In week one, each group focused on every goal they could reach by doing a lot of robotic activities. For a specific grade. Week two camp called Robotics, which is happening right now, is where the kids build their own bot competition. Now to the robotics camp counselors for more.
What am I doing? Right now I'm getting an interview done. A few minutes ago I was teaching some kids how to get their manipulator working for their robot with some rack and pinions. I think a lot of students have learned how to team build a lot better. A lot of them I know I've seen them from last year, and I know they seem a lot more experienced. And a lot of them come back with a lot more experience and a lot more maturity, which is always good to see. But over, since yesterday, I think they've all learned a bit more about how their robot's working and how their mechanics are. I think the hardest part of the camp is, you said this year?
Yeah.
This year, I think the hardest part is finding ways to keep kids engaged. Keeping them engaged is a good thing to do. We always try our best to do it, although it can be a struggle sometimes, especially if some kids are getting ahead of others. But we always find a way to keep kids engaged.
So this week we're running our Build-A-Bot camps, and the Build-A-Bot camps are in essence just a mini version of what we do for our actual robotic seasons. So what we do is we guide them through all of the things that we would do in an actual season. For example, we have them design a robot, we have them build the robot, we have them program the robot, and then we have them compete on a playing a game that we make ourselves. So far, what our students have learned is basically all of the stuff that we do in an FAC season, such as, for example, designing a robot, building a robot, for example, like literally how to put the screws on, how to wire a robot, and just skills that we want to see on our team when they get into high school. I'd say the hardest part is designing an effective robot that meets all the challenges, because our games always have a lot of different things that need to be done. And so if designing a robot that either does one thing and does it really well, or does a lot of things and does it really well, is a trade-off that they often have to make.
What are your students doing right now? Right now they are building robots and are preparing to use those robots to compete in our game this year. So far, they've learned design and engineering principles, they've learned teamwork and collaboration, and they're gonna have to learn more of those skills to, build robots, compete in games. The hardest part for the students is definitely communication within the teams and channeling, funneling all of those designs into one full, concept.
Thank you, counselors. This is Karina from Penn Camp. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Karina. Finally, Camper Linnea has all the info on this year's Palms Camp.
Palms is a mixture of cheer and dance. Penn students who participated in this year's Palms Camp assisted in coaching several grades of elementary to teach them a routine to share with their friends and family at the end of the week. On the grass outside Door D from June 10th to June 14th, around 100 elementary students were learning this week's routine.
We went to dance and then we found this and then we started doing this.
This camp is known to be a welcoming place for all that provides many opportunities.
I think it's just a really good opportunity for kids to learn palm routines, make friends, and it's just something fun to do in the summer, and I love teaching kids.
This is Linnea signing off of PNN.
Thank you, Linnea. Along with summer camps, summer school has also taken place this week to provide students a chance to catch up and get ahead.
Classes taking place this summer include physical education, health, geometry, and early college speech. Penn Teacher of the Year, Mr. Starkweather, is teaching the speech class.
I teach debate and speech, and I'd say English is, I think, the easiest way to put it is that I want to get people comfortable using their voice, whether that's in writing or in person. And I don't know how, I think everybody is afraid of public speaking. And I would say my one goal is to get them to where they can stand up in front of a group of people, and obviously everyone will be nervous, but to where they're not going to be totally, absolutely terrified.
Students have decided to take this course for several reasons. For example, C.J. Van Tine took the class to clear up space for electives next school year.
I love being able to get ahead and have that extra room because I have so much going on during the school year. And I also kind of have a say with who I have the class with because all of my friends are in summer speech, but there wouldn't be a guarantee if they were if I wasn't.
Some Penn summer schools take place online as well.
PHM Secondary Teacher of the Year was awarded to debate coach and sophomore English teacher during the last few weeks of school. Campers Charlotte, Gabby, and Jonna have more.
Past school year, Penn High School's very own Jeremy Starkweather won Teacher of the Year for his efforts as one of Penn High School's most dedicated and hardworking teachers. PNN reporter Anjana Palanisamy interviewed Mr. Starkweather about his experience.
So now that the school year is over, I've been teaching for 7 years.
So can you explain to us what Teacher of the Year means?
So Teacher of the Year, so they give an award to an elementary school teacher and a high school or middle school teacher every single year. And I've kind of said this before, but like at Penn High School, we just have some of the most incredible teachers in the area. And so to get this award like really means a lot to me because there are plenty of deserving people. And so to get it, yeah, it makes me very proud. So,
how did you feel when you learned that you were going to become the Teacher of the Year?
I was very surprised. So I actually got called into the office by my principal, and he didn't really tell me why. And then I was like, okay, I hope I'm not in trouble or anything. I don't know why I would be. But anyway, so then he talks to me, and it's all about my schedule for next year. And then we go back to my class. And then I open up the door, and there are just all these TV cameras and these bright lights, and all the desks are moved, and my class and everybody in the room and my principal and superintendent and everybody is just staring at me. You know, and surprise, Teacher of the Year. So I was very surprised. I think that's a fair way to put it. So,
what motivated you to become a teacher in the first place?
Oh, that's a good question. I actually went my first year of college, I was undecided, so I didn't really know what I was going to do, and I kind of always went back and forth. I always thought, like, one of my, I think, best skills, not, you know, I've always kind of been like a jack of all trades, master of none kind of a guy, but one thing that I was always usually pretty good at is talking to people, and so I thought teaching would be a good option for me. And then I obviously loved debate when I was in high school, and I went to college, and I took an English class, and I loved it. I took a calculus class, and I was like, math is not going to be something that I'm going to teach. But anyways, I thought it would be a lot of fun. And then now here I am 7 years later, and I'm an English teacher, and it is a lot of fun. So
that'll be all. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
For PNN, we are Gabby Hintz, Anjana Palanisamy, and Charlotte Chung back to the desk.
Penn is getting a new turf and new track this fall. Construction began as soon as school ended, and it's coming along quickly. Campers Jose and David have more.
Right now I'm recording. Major changes are coming to Everwise Freed Field this summer. Right now, the stadium is off limits as construction crews are out destroying the turf and track to prepare for some renovations. Construction started this week and is expected to last all summer. Some of the renovations planned are a new turf on the football field, and the track will be resurfaced.
Why are you getting a new football field?
The old football turf was about 14 years old, and it was getting run down. It's used by so many different groups, not just football, lacrosse, PE classes. Our band uses it throughout the year, and so, yeah, it's used by thousands of students here.
Construction is going to have a big impact on summer conditioning for Penn sports teams. We'll be relocating to other places around Penn and Schmucker to accommodate. Currently, track athletes are also having to relocate due to the construction.
Last time any major construction happened out at Freed Field was in 2010. This project is expected to wrap up the 22nd of August. Just in time for football season, reporting for PNN, I'm Jose.
And I'm David.
Thanks. Now to sports news. While construction may cause disruptions to sports camps, they are still happening at Penn,
including the basketball camp. Coach Mudlin, Coach Smith, and Coach Coleman are running for a basketball camp for kids from kindergarten through third grade. It wrapped up Thursday in the auxiliary gym and the main arena. Students got to have fun with their friends while learning basketball skills.
Coach Maudlin explains how he and his fellow coaches are giving kids K through third grade an early intro into a sport that will bring them a long way in the future.
I coach because I love the game myself, and it's a good opportunity for these younger kids to learn how to play. It gives them a good chance to meet new friends, and it gives them more responsibility to help them with life.
Basketball camp was just one of many sports camps happening this summer. Visit the PHM website for a full list of summer camps. That's all we have today in sports. Now back to the desk.
Thank you, Lily and Charlotte. And that is all we have created for this week, Penn. Thank you for tuning into this special version of PNN.